within the way that you weave your web of lies and delusions. But we know what's real, do we not? We know what's right, do we not? We know what's wrong, do we not? You don't just forget about these things. You know it deep down within your heart. You know it within your subconscious. But yet, you want to try and excuse and validate that bad attitude. What's good, everyone? Just out here getting after it once again. You know what it is. And I hope all you guys out there are doing just the same, continuing on this journey to be able to create better individuals to give back to your dogs and your family units. Now, I just got back from that morning run, getting my cardio in, all the rest of it, yada yada. And I was thinking to myself that your weakness is not a virtue. Your weakness within the way you hold yourself, your personal conduct, within the way you construct and cultivate your own character, is not to be disguised as a virtue. Think to yourself, what do I mean when I talk about such things? What is it that I mean when I say this? Do you actually understand what it is that I'm saying? Because you know what? It's something that we need to attach our awareness to. Let me explain. If you are an individual that is scared to say and do the things that need to be said and done, that is weakness, is it not? If you are scared to be misunderstood by speaking the truth, you get nervous and you get shook when it's your time to be truly honest with somebody. How can you call yourself a reliable individual if you're too concerned with people pleasing because you're too scared to keep it raw and to keep it real with those around you, with your peers, brothers, sisters, family, with your children? How can you be a trustworthy person? If you are scared to set boundaries, how can you be an individual that has a healthy respect of self? All of these different things, in all of these different areas, it's weakness, is it not? And if you are one of these individuals, why would you try to excuse that weakness as a virtue? Why would you try to disguise your weakness as kindness? Let me ask you a question. Is it because we've been socially conditioned to seek out that feel-good love? That love that only ever makes you feel good? There's a saying, facts don't give a fuck about your feelings. And I'll be the first one to say, fuck your feelings. Because the way you feel does not determine the way reality needs to bend and warp itself around you. The world will work in the way it works within the laws that govern the reality that we live in. It is not going to change, nor is it going to warp, wield, or bend due to your misguided states of emotion. So therefore, some of you people that do just that, that disguise your weakness, that disguises your cowardice as acts of kindness, you do not have the right to call that a virtue. You do not have the right to hide behind true moral virtue, because you're trying to use that kindness like you're above challenging yourself. So how can you call yourself a virtuous individual? You cannot. You're trying to hide your weakness and hide the fact that you're a coward behind the moral virtue. For you people out there on the other end of the spectrum, on the opposite side of the tracks, you people with a little bit more gusto, that like to throw your weight around, that like to seek out conflict, confrontation, and all the rest of it. The same thing goes for you. You need to learn how to cultivate self to be able to be a little bit more forgiving, understanding, to learn how to find a common ground. Because it's easy for you to point the finger, isn't it? It's easy for you to hold on to that resentment, isn't it? It's easy for you to behave within a bitter and spiteful state of mind, isn't it? To play tit for tat, to play all that kind of yada yada bullshit, because you're too busy trying to be right rather than do what is right. You talk about setting the example, but yet you fail to lead by example by being a living example. You want to hold people to a standard? Well, then set the standard to self first. Stop pointing the finger. Understand that the way you're behaving is just a projection of that resentment and bullshit that you're holding within. That negativity, that hurt, that pain that you're holding within. And yet, you want to point the finger at everyone else. Look at the way you're behaving. Look at the way you try and push your weight around. Look at the way you think everyone just needs to uphold themselves to your views. These things and these matters are objective. They are not subjective. We all know what is truly right and wrong. These things are not up for debate. You can try and hide behind all the intricacies behind it all, within the way that you weave your web of lies and delusions. But we know what's real, do we not? We know what's right, do we not? We know what's wrong, do we not? You don't just forget about these things. You know it deep down within your heart. You know it within your subconscious. But yet, you want to try and excuse and validate that bad attitude, that spiteful bullshit, that resentment, that bitterness, passing it on to everybody else. For you individuals, the virtue is learning how to forgive, is learning how to be more forgiving, is learning how to find common ground within understanding, and understand that people can only ever meet you to the depths that they've met themselves. And yes, that does go for you too. This is why some of these conversations must be had. This is why these conversations are essential. This is why these conversations are so powerful for where they stem from where their foundation actually lies and are built upon. Just like the individual that's scared to step up and that's scared to be misunderstood, to say and do the things that need to be said and done. Their virtue is found within becoming stronger within self, becoming stronger, more resilient within their character, becoming an individual that's actually about it, that just doesn't talk about it, that holds themselves to their moral obligation of standing up for their convictions in who they truly are. How can you be a protector and provider in its true essence without doing so? If you cannot uphold yourself within these areas, you're just weak, are you not? And for you individuals out there that want to throw your weight around, Your virtue is learning to find that softer side of you instead of excusing your issues within your irritability, frustration, anger, resentment, and all the rest of it. Learning to seek the answers within so that you can learn to release that negativity, that bullshit that you hold within. Forgiveness is not always for the other side. A lot of the time, it's for you. It doesn't mean that you have to forget, but it allows you to release the bullshit that you hold yourself attached to. Remember the saying, be selfish to be selfless. Learn to detach yourself from these things to find a true virtue within your own character. Even think about this, the little children. Whenever they don't get their way, what's the first thing that they do? They throw a temper tantrum. That negativity. That lack of control. That frustration is all being released, is it not? So what's the easiest thing to do? To live within that resentment, to live within that anger, to blame the hatred, to play victim to your internal state of emotions. Is it not? This is why the virtue is to be found within forgiveness. And for the first example, the virtue is to be found within strength. I hope that little bit of food for thought can help. I hope that can create some power within your insight to do better, to be about it and not just talk about it. God bless. Peace.